If you weren't looking for it, you would probably drive right past the greenhouse with yellow shutters on the corner. Doesn't look like much from the outside. But this is where two ordinary people stood their ground against a bunch of neighborhood bad guys and won. Curt and Sharon Gillins grew up on this East End section of Galveston Island, Texas.
We had a great childhood here in this town. We didn't know we were poor. We had no idea. We ate well, we got a good education, and we had opportunities available to us. And that was in the late 60s.
But by the time the Gillins moved back to Galveston a few years later, the old neighborhood had turned into a crime-infested wasteland. There were few signs of hope and even less sense of community. In fact, many residents of this part of town had been driven out by one of the 10 major hurricanes that have hit this Gulf Coast island since 1900. But the Gillins went ahead with their plan to open a coffee shop.
I was once told that this our business was like a little bit of heaven in the middle of hell. And there was customers that would come in and say this was a beacon. And, you know, it was like a beacon in the middle of nowhere.
Sidewalk paintings made by neighborhood children tell the story of a happy place where people came to sip a cup of joe and to talk and enjoy each other. But just across the street from the greenhouse on the corner, there was trouble.
And drug dealers used to hang out across the street and sell drugs. And when we opened our business, I went to them and I told them, you know, hey, I'm opening my business here. I appreciate if you guys would sell your drugs somewhere else. And they actually told me that this has been a drug area long before you came here, and it will always be a drug area. And I told them, okay, we're going to see about that.
Neglect allowed this environment, this unhealthy environment, to thrive. And so, yes, the drug addicts and the drug dealers felt empowered because it had been relinquished to them. No one had asked to have it back. We came and said, we want it back for the people. The people who lived around here were afraid, literally, to say anything.
No wonder. Twice the drug dealers firebombed the greenhouse on the corner, hoping to drive the Gillins out.
Well, God is good, and you know, the house did not burn either time. The building didn't burn either time. They were crackheads. They did a lousy job of burning the place down.
But as the drug dealers turned up the heat, Curt became more determined to protect his greenhouse on the corner.
And I said, no, we're not moving. We're not going to let some nickel and dime dope dealers run us off of our own property. We're taxpayers. So anyway, we finally end up getting the neighborhood pretty much, you know, cleaned up with the help of Galveston Police Department and city officials.
Then came Hurricane Ike. Sharon showed us the high water mark almost above her head on a B.B. King frame poster on the wall.
Everything in the place had floated up.
The public housing project across the street from the greenhouse on the corner was destroyed by floodwater and today is an empty lot. The park where the drug dealers hung out was closed. New private homes stand there today. And now, both at the age of 60, Curt and Sharon Gillins are starting over again at the greenhouse on the corner.
I wouldn't mind. I'd love to see this become a neighborhood grocery store again, a meat market, something that will support the health of the people in the area. You know, as long as the building is in the family, we have the option to serve this community. So that's what we're looking forward to, serving this community in whatever way it evolves.
But whatever happens, the Gillins are glad to be home, in whatever shape home is in, and they remain optimistic about the future.
Because living at the beach is a good thing. It's a wonderful thing. Water is healing, and we are surrounded by water.
And when another hurricane comes, and it will,
you just deal with it. Pull up your pants, stop crying, you get 24 hours to whine, and then after that, go to work.